How to remove an ingrown hair quickly without any lasers whatsoever. Ingrown hairs plague many of us. They're those coarse hairs that disguise themselves as inflamed bumps after what we thought was a safe, close shave. They are painful, but the most annoying part is trying to figure out how to get rid of ingrown hairs. They're hard to get rid of, and sometimes it feels like that ingrown hair will be with us for the rest of our life. I've been plagued with ingrown hair since I started shaving. They used to keep me in slightly prudish bathing suits, prevent me from having sex with the lights on, and it's keep me up at night fighting the urge to hunt for hours to find the location of the trapped curl and tweeze the crap out of it. If you find yourself nodding your head, saying yes, child, or anything similar, then you've been in this situation before. It's time to treat ingrown hairs and provide some much-needed relief and confidence. Don't worry. The best methods to treat ingrown hairs don't involve OTC treatments or scary lasers. Here's an all-natural, 4-step process for getting rid of those pesky little bumps. 1. Exfoliate the area. Most likely, you want to get rid of your ingrown hair before it becomes an enormous, painful bump. Exfoliate the affected area twice daily with a mixture of baking soda, raw honey, and nutmeg powder. The combination of these ingredients will remove dead skin cells and decrease inflammation, plus the honey will keep the area from over-drying. This helps bring the hair to the head. 2. Apply heat. Once you see the tip of the hair, you can use a hot compress to make the skin soft and open up pores to help the hair come out smoother. Run a washcloth under hot water and press down on the location for about 10 minutes. 3. Free the trapped hair. Always make sure you use a clean, sharp tool to extract the ingrown hair. I use a pointed tip pair of tweezers and always soak them in rubbing alcohol between uses to avoid causing irritation or infection from any bacteria that the blades can be exposed to. This part can be tricky, because you want to get the entire hair without breaking it off at the skin and having to go through the whole process again. The best way to avoid that is to wait until the hair has some length beyond the skin, and make sure you have strong tweezers. 4. Bring down the inflammation. The most important step is the final step, bring down the inflammation and cool down the area. For an OTC aftershave treatment, Dry Shea Moisture's Tea Tree Herbal Bump Preventer. It's loaded with natural anti-inflammatory ingredients and vitamin E, so it will speed up the healing process. You can DIY the treatment as well. I use 3 parts rose water to 1 part aloe vera, plus equal parts tea tree oil and witch hazel. I keep my mixture in the refrigerator so that the cold liquid will also help bring down any inflammation caused by tweezing the ingrown hair. This has definitely saved me from having a simple removal of an ingrown hair become a week-long project. If you simply pluck out the hair, you irritate the skin and risk scarring. These steps will definitely point you in the opposite direction of getting an infected ingrown hair and help extract the hair, but sadly for some of us, especially us curly-haired folks, ingrown hairs are an inevitable beauty crisis. Fortunately, natural prevention and treatments are painless and affordable.